Hi, and welcome to this Leica talk. My name is Mark Valti, and today we are in the studio of our beautiful lights park in Wetzlar, and I have a very special guest with Peter Kruschewski.
Hello, Mark. Thanks for the invitation.
You're very welcome. Peter, first things first, what are you doing at Leica?
I'm the product manager for compact and instant cameras since 2008 at Leica, and being responsible for the Q family since the first generation of the Q, the Type 116, hit the market in June 2015.
So you're actually our Mr. Q.
I'm not so deeply involved in R&D, but I take this as a compliment. Thank you very much.
You should, because you're responsible for a very successful product of Leica. Why is the Q family so successful, Peter?
Because I think it's the superior image quality combined with the overall great performance and the design with the iconic touch of a Leica M, I think. And secondly, it's the ease of use, the reduction to the essentials. The camera holds no frills, no unnecessary operating elements. It's just the camera that does what it's supposed to do, and this is taking great images.
So it's a family with the Leica Q, with the Leica Q2, and of course we are here because we have a new family member, and I can't wait to hear a little bit more. I'm very excited. What did you bring with you?
Yeah, Mark, indeed. I brought something very special with me today. It's the brand new Leica Q2 monochrome, and it's the first of its kind.
Monochrome, something new indeed, and I can see the design changed a little bit as well. What is different from a design perspective?
First and foremost, this camera is as reliable and as robust as a sister model with the color sensor. And of course, the Q2 monochrome is dust and spray waterproofed. In terms of the design, it's even more minimalistic and unobtrusive by having a really clear front without the Leica logo, a matte black painted lens and body, the middle grain leatherette that was taken over from the M10 monochrome, and even the monochrome engraving on the top of the camera is not highlighted but inked in black. Last but not least, all letterings and engravings on the camera are kept in black, gray and white.
Absolutely, absolutely gorgeous from far, and I want to touch it and feel it. There is obviously a fair bit of new elements onto it. If I remember right, it's about 18 months that we have launched Leica Q2. What happened within this 18 months on technology? What did you work on and what did you do to make this as it is today, Peter?
Right, Mark. It took now almost 18 months to develop this new baby here with the new sensor. And as you know, Leica stands for black and white photography. And we have a long history with monochrome cameras. And to get in those large footsteps, it's somewhat quite a bit of a challenge, because by knowing about the high optical performance of an M monochrome, for instance, the team around the Q, they knew right from the start that we have to get at least very close to the performance of it. And without getting too much into details, I can say that it's not just about taking away the color filter or the cover glass from the sensor and that's it. No, there are much more efforts and challenges to develop a monochrome sensor for a compact camera like the Q. And this took a little bit of time, you're right.
So there's a lot of technology in it. What is then the benefit for our customers now with all of this, what's inside?
Obviously, it's the high natural sharpness and the clear detail of the images. Even low contrast and fine details can be captured better. The background for this is that the interpolation to complete the color information is not necessary. And that leads to even better results and higher resolution. And based on that, the ISO range could be extended from 100 to 100,000 with a higher dynamic range and less noise even under low light conditions. And by the way, Mark, if you want to focus manually and if you love black and white photography, the Q2 monochrome is the one and only alternative here. Same for macros in black and white. You can go very close to the object after switching to the macro mode of the camera. And overall, we can say that the images that are coming from a monochrome sensor are different. They are even more crisp and lightly with detailed highlights even under high contrast lighting conditions.
That sounds like a lot have happened in here, what you have put into. But Peter, you know, a picture can say more than 1,000 words. And I know you brought some pictures with you. And I would like proof, of course.
Exactly. So as I spend lots of my spare time in Cologne, we grabbed the cue to Monochrom and went out for shooting. And where do you go when you're in Cologne? You go to the cathedral, of course. And we were standing in front of it and took this image, first of all. And you already can see the sharpness and the details here in that image.
It's beautiful.
And if you crop in 100% and take a look on this part of the window here, you can see the structure of every single window on that image. And this was somehow stunning for us at that moment, because we could not see those details when we were standing in front of the cathedral with our naked eyes. So this was somehow very, very impressive here.
So even after the crop on 100%, all the details are visible. It's beautiful contrast. It's wonderful.
Exactly.
You have another picture. You did some street photography.
Yes, you're right. We went to the south of Cologne on a very busy street there. It was at the weekend, and we took an image and stopped down to 5.6 and took this image out of the hand with a 1/25 of a second. And you can see, because of this fact, you can see this nice dynamic blur here at this woman on the bike, or at these people who are crossing the street. The interesting thing here is, if you crop in 100%,
wow,
you can still see all the data details here on the background and the sharpness of this crop here.
So no tripod used?
No
really
tripod
just
used, just taken out of the hand,
wow,
with 1/25 of a second. And that shows the excellent working image stabilization of the Q2 in general. So this is a really good example for this.
So it's really a camera for a day-to-day use, and for a quick shot, even on a busy street like here. And how does then, we have a 47 million pixel sensor, Peter, and the lens, how does that work together? Is this working really well? Did you?
It works.
Think about it enough?
It works. It's a key, yes. And we had lots of discussions with the optical engineers and Peter Carber and his team, if this is even possible, that this lens is up to the performance of that sensor. And after talking several times, everybody was convinced that there is a clear yes. Because we have to understand here that in a fixed lens camera like the Q, you have much more space and flexibility as far as the optical design is concerned. Why is that? Because you don't need a focal plane shutter, because the central shutter is already built in the lens, and of course you don't need a lens mount. And this enables our engineers to realize a more symmetric lens design with larger lenses very close to the image sensor of the camera. And a symmetric lens design like that can be much better corrected than a lens for a system camera, for instance. Such a performance can basically not be achieved in that compact size for an interchangeable lens.
So basically the perfect compact camera, and I think I just want to go out and get it tested. But before we do this, I have a very personal or private question, and it's just you and I here. Peter, we all know we can do in post-production, every colored picture can be easily put into black and white. Do I really need such a camera, like a Leica Q2 monochrome?
That's a very good question. But I can tell you, Mark, if you go out, grab a camera, take some images, you will never ask me this question again. Of course, you can tweak your images up to the limit afterwards, but what I can tell you is that you will not be able to reproduce an image that's coming from a monochrome sensor in terms of details, sharpness, and original look of the images.
So really something that everybody should grab a Leica Q2 monochrome, get out, take a picture, print it, or watch it on a screen, and you're sure that easy
exactly
to see the difference.
Exactly.
I already thought that you were going to tell me that. How about video functionality? Is video functionality in this camera as well?
Of course. And I tell you, a black and white video in 4K or Cine 4K is amazing. And of course, you have the same advantages for video than you have for still images. And by the way, black and white films are not out of trend. If you look out, there are still some productions like Lighthouses, Willem Dafoe, or Sin City, one of my favorites, and both movies have been recorded in black and white. The background for this is somehow, I think, the mood that was intended to be transported and brought to the audience was furthermore impressively emphasized by the recording in black and white.
I'm impressed what kind of technology is all in this wonderful beauty in front of us. Is there anything else you would like to add?
What I would like and love to tell everybody is that it's not important to take the perfect image or the perfect photo. It's just about the joy of photography. Just grab a camera, go out, have fun, and take the images that you love to take. And don't forget, those are memories that you will have your whole life long.
Peter, thank you for being here. We look forward to put our hands on a Leica Q2 Monochrom. Thanks for your work, and see you soon.
Thank you very much.